Tonight's headlines are brought to you by McDonald's.
Good evening, Commonwealth, and thanks for watching the Channel 2 News. I'm Sally Lemus. Let's take a look at tonight's top stories. Federal court unseals several indictments. Also tonight, voters are out early this year, exercising their right and deciding who the next leaders will be. And the community welcomes the transformation of a brand name hotel. In sports, running is fun with this team. Stay with us, these stories and more are next.
Fast, fun, and easy. That's how your home Wi-Fi should be. So start with an internet plan that fits your budget. Introducing your home Wi-Fi starter pack, also known as WISP. Enjoy up to 25 megabits per second for as low as $35 a month. Plus, a free router with your wireless subscription. That's hours of movies, games, social media, and more endless fun. Get your Wi-Fi starter pack today only at Docomo Pacific. Better together. Additional conditions may apply.
We're boxing for days and we love to fish, but at the same time, we also always dive safe and we always dive with a partner.
Ooh, yeah, yeah. Culture, culture, culture. Culture, culture, culture. Culture, culture, culture. Culture, culture, culture. Say they want the culture. Culture. Eat it up, turn them to vultures. The vultures. Migos gang pull up like soldiers. Gang. And when we pull up, we got chauffeurs. Chauffeurs. Tell them do it for the culture. The culture. Got to do it for the culture. Do it for the culture. Tell them do it for the culture. The culture. Got to do it for the culture. Do it culture. Culture. I wake up and I thank God and I go strong.
Very thankful for everybody that's like taking their time to, you know, look into this. Governor, the government officials, like everybody that's part of this, like I would like to like thank them a lot. It's a big help, like really, not just changing like our lives, but it can start up ours and then we can start changing other people's lives within Saipan.
Brought to you by the Office of the Governor.
Enjoy the deliciously saucy McRib. Only for a limited time and only at McDonald's.
The legendary McRib is back. Pair it with fries and a drink for a limited time.
We are the administrators for the Boost program. Yes, and I'm even nervous, but we're here to present you your first Boost
package. Yep.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much. Is this really happening right now?
Yeah.
Oh my God. This is real?
We will do our best to keep on doing what we do. And once again, thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you, Mr. Governor, Governor Ralph Torres. Couldn't have a better opportunity than this.
Brought to you by the Office of the Governor.
Day to the Wami and good evening, Commonwealth. Today is Wednesday, November 2nd, 2022. Indictments have been unsealed in federal court against 17 individuals who may have attempted to float their way out of the Commonwealth. Our Chris Nelson has more.
United States says that illegal aliens from Saipan attempted to illegally sneak into Guam this summer by boat. Two indictments were unsealed this week, each alleging that a different group of individuals attempted to smuggle themselves into Guam. Charging documents were filed in the middle of October but have been under seal. That was lifted this week. U.S. says that the defendants are citizens of the People's Republic of China. The defendants do not have, nor at the time of the alleged offense, did have valid legal immigration status in the United States of America. The U.S. says they pooled their money together to purchase a boat. One boat, they say, they acquired for $32,000. That's a 26-footer with a white fiberglass hull. CNMI boat registration number CM0057CP. They say this boat was used by eight defendants and one additional Chinese citizen who also did not have lawful immigration status. U.S. says they headed to Guam by boat on July 31st, landing at the Agana boat basin. Also in July 2022, 1 week prior, different boat, this time a 20-footer with a fiberglass hull, CM4718PU, was purchased for $20,000, also landing in the Agana boat basin. Authorities located the boat after it came ashore with the defendants in July. Defendants, at least some of them, have been returned to Saipan. Each will get their own attorney. An initial appearance happened this week, but bail has not yet been set. All defendants who have been apprehended are in custody, and each now has their own attorney, but some are still at large. Defendants are due back in court on Thursday. Bail conditions are expected to be set then.
The election is underway, and close to 3% of registered voters have made some very important decisions. Early voting is ongoing.
Hundreds of voters head down to the multipurpose center in Susupi for the second day of early voting. Commonwealth Election Commission Executive Director Kayla Igito says the numbers have been pretty big so far.
We have a lot of voters coming out to vote. Numbers are big. It's only been the second day, but yesterday we had a total of 655 voters voting. Yesterday here on Saipan. And then in Tinian we had 47. In Rota we had 57. And it looks like the numbers are going to be high today as well.
As of 2:30 p.m. today, the count totaled to more than 560 voters for the second day. According to the CEC website, there are 19,275 registered voters. Precinct 3B has the largest number of voters, more than 3,000, followed by Precinct 5, 2,975. Igito says there are also many voters who are taking advantage of the curbside voting.
Curbside voting has been good. It's been busy. You know, a lot of voters are taking advantage of that. The ones that are elderly or disabled, they come over and they do the curbside, which is good for them.
Did they have to like register online?
No, they don't. They just come over here, provide us their ID. If they don't have one, we'll bring out the form, that no ID affidavit. Then we'll go ahead and assist them. And then the ballot's brought out to them.
Across the multi-purpose center are the three political group camps. Democrat Party Chairman Jonathan Cabrera says they are excited and looking forward to the results.
Party, our candidates have been working very hard, and we're hopeful that because they've made their case to the people of the CNMI, that we're going to get the results that we're hoping to get on election night.
Former Fire Chief Clyde Narita from the Arnold Dave 2022 team says the numbers are looking good.
It's a great early voting. The numbers that we estimated to be voting every day has been exceeded. That means our people are responsive to all of the campaigns from the camps, obviously. And so we're glad that people are coming out in early voting. Like today, November 2nd, All Souls Day. We would think that people would rather give time to the church, you know, the cemetery. But the numbers today have exceeded yesterday's number. So that's great. People are coming out to vote early.
NMI Republican Party Chairman James Atta.
You know, so far it's kind of slow, but the people are going out to vote. And again, I wanted to echo all the people that are going out there, especially first-time voters, to please exercise your rights to vote in this election.
It's now 5 days until the general election, and the parties say the days ahead are looking pretty busy.
You know, they're still going house to house. They're still meeting with supporters. You know, it's still trying to get out the vote, continuing to make their case up to the very last minute, because every vote counts and every vote matters. So we're just here, at the early election headquarters for at least for the next couple of days, and we invite our supporters in. We talk to them, people who stop by our tent after they voted, and just helping folks learn more, even more, about why they need to vote Democrat this election.
Continue our early voting. Reach out to all of our constituents, our supporters, families, and friends. And try to hit the early voting, get that out of the way. We think that getting the early voting out of the way would help us with concentrating on election day, which is the intense part of the campaign. And of course, hopefully, we get our messages out to everybody. And that's to come in, cast your votes for Arno and Dave 2022 and the team.
You probably see it when we started Monday preparation. You can see there's a lot of supporters that are here. We started out yesterday very early, and again, we started again early this morning, and I've seen a lot of our people, and of course we have seen a lot of new faces and young guns that are here. And again, we have 5 more days before the D-Day, and I encourage again all the people of the Commonwealth, the great Commonwealth, to please go out and exercise your fiduciary right. And again, I would always say this, always mention, please vote Troy Sablan and of course all the Republican candidates.
Garapan has a new tenant with over 400 rooms. As a new hotel opens its front door and hopefully a lot of guest doors in the coming years. Let's take a look inside the Crown Plaza. This hotel was first known as Daiichi Hotel, and then it was later rebranded into the Fiesta Resort and Spa. Looking for something bigger, the Tan Holdings invested in transforming the hotel into an internationally managed property. Following a $43 million renovation, it now stands as Crown Plaza Saipan.
This is the beginning of the journey that we want to play a part to elevate CNMI into a world-class destination that will bring in the tourists back and tourists that are actually going to spend in our economy and provide the jobs for our people.
It's the first Crown Plaza resort in the Micronesian region, joining 400 other hotels around the world under the brand name. Abhijay Sandilya of the Intercontinental Hotel Group, better known as IHG, congratulates the Tan family for investing in what he calls the future of Saipan tourism and the future of the hospitality industry.
We know our hotels come to life through our people. And again, even for our people, as it has been for everyone, it has been the toughest time our industry has ever seen. But I can assure you, looking at the return of business around the world, in other parts of the world, in Europe, in America, in Australia, where we monitor business on a daily basis, we see a great spring back of business and a great spring back of people wanting to travel and get back out there and connect with its own vacation or business. And we're very, very confident that Saipan will continue to welcome guests from around the world and bring back tourism to this wonderful island as we all know it.
Over 200 government and industry officials were in attendance of the Crown Plaza grand opening on Monday, including Governor Ralph Torres, who says it is not only a milestone for the CNMI, but a success story as well.
And Jerry, being the chairman for Governor's Economic Council of Advisors, we looked at this whole holistic approach of tourism and not just the renewal of this lease, but as you've seen all around, our tourist site continue to make an investment on our tourist site. So yeah, this is definitely a success story for all of us.
Tan Holdings locks in a 40-year lease on the property. Many of these conversations and projects were led by Jennifer Tan, who is the director of SIA Leisure. Jennifer, who is fairly new to the family business, says they are confident the tourism industry will thrive in Saipan.
I've always said to everyone around, Saipan is beautiful. Saipan is world-class in its natural resources. So our family, Tan family, firmly believes in our investment here. It will take time to recover, no doubt, no lies about that. But I am very, very confident that as the economy returns, as the world opens up, we'll be bustling again.
According to Regional General Manager Thomas Meyerhofer, they have been open for the past 2 weeks, picking up rooms every day. Their hope is to reach at least a 25% occupancy rate by December. Crown Plaza Saipan has 422 guest rooms and 5 restaurants with a new Italian head chef.
What we really wanted to do was to be a contemporary resort. And I think if you look at us, from the minute you walk in, you have a view of the ocean. You see the blue colors. You see it in the guest rooms. You see it in our outlets. We've got some very exciting food and beverage outlets. We've got the marketplace, which is directly behind me. You know, we've got the terrace restaurant, which is, we brought in a new chef from Italy. We're very, very excited about Gennaro being our chef here. We will bring back my teppanyaki early next year, so it'll take us a little bit while and everything in stages. But, you know, really, it's the guest rooms and it's this whole modern resort experience where you really can make beautiful memories in the sunset of Micronesia or Micro Beach.
For more information on bookings, you can visit their website online or call them at 670-234-6412. All right, coming up, a drive-through distribution event is happening tomorrow. Stay tuned if you're interested.
Need a new phone? Trade in now and get up to $500 off our best 5G devices. Trade in your older phone in any condition and step up to better savings and speeds only our 5G network can provide. Check out our website and catch up on the best mobile experience. Trade in now. Docomo Pacific, better together.
We're boxing for days and we love to fish. But at the same time, we also always dive safe and we always dive with a partner. Ooh, yeah, yeah.
Culture. Say they want the culture. Culture. Eat it up, turn them to vultures. The vultures. Migos gang pull up like soldiers. Gang. And when we pull up, we got chauffeurs. Chauffeurs. Tell them do it for the culture. The culture. Got to do it for the culture.
Do it for the culture.
Tell them do it for the culture.
The culture.
Got to do it for the culture.
Do it for
culture.
The culture.
I wake up and I thank God and I go strong.
Very thankful for everybody that's like taking their time to, you know, look into this. Governor, the government officials, like everybody that's part of this, like I would like to like thank them a lot. It's a big help, like really, not just changing like our lives, but it can start up ours and then we can start changing other people's lives within Saipan.
Brought to you by the Office of the Governor.
We have important decisions to make about our leadership in government and the kind of future we want for our Commonwealth. We can choose the same old leadership, and we will get the same old school politics. Or we can choose to change. Vote for leaders you can trust. Leaders who won't lie to you or steal from you. Vote for Layla and me, and we will help and work for everyone.
This message is approved and paid for by the committee to elect Christina Sablon and Layla Staffler.
We are the administrators for the Boost program.
Oh,
yes, and I'm even nervous, but we're here to present you your first Boost badge.
Oh. Yep.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much. Is this really happening right now?
Yeah.
Oh my God. This is real? We will do our best to keep on doing what we do. And once again, thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you, Mr. Governor, Governor Ralph Torres. Couldn't have a better opportunity than this.
Brought to you by the Office of the Governor.
Welcome back to the Channel 2 News. Bail modification is denied for a repeat offender with an extensive rap sheet.
45-year-old Mario Sablon is no stranger to the criminal justice system. His 5-page rap sheet says so. Sablon is currently facing burglary and theft charges after he allegedly broke into the home of a former lawmaker. Sablon, through his lawyer Tyler Scott, asked the court to be released to a third-party custodian as he awaits trial. Chief Prosecutor Chester Hines asked the court to deny his bail modification request given his long criminal and drug-related history. Judge Joseph Camacho weighed the situation carefully for at least an hour. Judge Camacho found the uncle, a former police officer, to be acceptable as a third-party custodian, but he says Sablon has been given many chances in the past. The bail modification was denied and Sablon was remanded back to the Department of Corrections. Sablon and his co-defendant Shayna Kostru are currently awaiting their jury trial set for February of next year. They have both pleaded not guilty to the charges.
The CNMI Office of the Governor, together with Grants and Management and State Clearinghouse, will be distributing free sacks of rice tomorrow, November 3rd. On Thursday, November 3, the Governor's Office, through OGM, will be giving out 50 pounds of short or long grain rice sacks in a drive-through event for Saipan residential households. The Food Security Outreach Program will be held at 3 locations around Saipan: the Coblerville Youth Center, Garapan Fishing Base, and Cagman Community Center. The drive-through event begins at 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Those interested must bring a valid ID and a hard copy of their most recent CUC billing. Digital copies or electronic format will not be accepted. One billing is limited to one sack of rice. The items will be distributed on a first-come, first-served basis. All right, folks, don't go anywhere because we have sports up next.
Fast, fun, and easy. That's how your home Wi-Fi should be. So start with an internet plan that fits your budget. Introducing your home Wi-Fi starter pack, also known as WISP. Enjoy up to 25 megabits per second for as low as $35 a month, plus a free router with your wireless subscription. That's hours of movies, games, social media, and more endless fun. Get your Wi-Fi starter pack today only at Docomo Pacific. Better together. Additional conditions may apply.
We are the administrators for the Boost program.
Oh my.
Yes, and I'm even nervous, but we're here to present you your first Boost badge.
Oh. Yep.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much. Is this really happening right now?
Yeah.
Oh my God. This is real? We will do our best to keep on doing what we do. And once again, thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you, Mr. Governor, Governor Ralph Torres. Couldn't have a better opportunity than this.
Brought to you by the Office of the Governor.
My doctor gave me the pills, so they must be safe, right?
If taken exactly as prescribed, short-term use can be safe, but painkillers have real risk. Misusing an opioid painkiller can cause serious harm, including addiction and death, and misuse can happen quite easily. Make sure you never mix them with alcohol, antidepressants, sedatives, or sleep aids. And if you are prescribed an opioid, you need to tell your doctor about any other drugs, including herbal supplements, that you are taking. It only takes a little to lose a lot.
This project was supported by a grant from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention and the Commonwealth Healthcare Corporation. Contents are solely the responsibility of CHCC and do not necessarily represent the official views of the CDC or the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
I tell you what, a woman is more knowledgeable about what's happening. And so now is the time to put her in. I think Tina and Staffler will do a good thing.
Yes.
I think it's about time we change. Not only that, but I think a woman is, it's time for a woman to be the head of the government.
I agree.
This message is approved and paid for by the committee to elect Christina Sablon and Layla Staffler.
Green sea turtles and hawksbill turtles call the Mariana Islands home. They're an important part of the marine ecosystem. They are under threat, and they are protected under CNMI law. Keep plastic out of the ocean. Keep vehicles off the beach. Use the sea turtle stranding hotline if you see poaching activities or if you see a turtle in trouble. Call 287-8537 and save a turtle.
We're focusing for days, and we love to fish. But at the same time, we also always dive safe and we always dive with a partner.
Ooh, yeah, yeah. Culture, culture, culture. Culture, culture, culture. Culture, culture, culture. Culture, culture, culture. Say they want the culture. Culture. Eat it up, turn them to vultures. Migos gang pull up like soldiers. Now when we pull up, we got chauffeurs. Chauffeurs, tell them do it for the culture. Try to do it for the culture. Do it for the culture. Tell them do it for the culture. Try to do it for the culture. Do it culture. I wake up and I thank God and I go strong. I thank God. I wake up and look in my eyes and put it on.
Very thankful for everybody that's like taking their time to, you know, look into this. Governor, the government officials, everybody that's part of this, like, I would like to like thank them a lot. It's a big help, like, really, not just changing like our lives, but it can start up ours, and then we can start changing other people's lives within Saipan.
Brought to you by the Office of the Governor.
Tonight's sports brought to you in part by TAN Holdings through the Tan Soo Lin Foundation, making communities a better place to live.
Buenas sports fans.
For our KSPN Sports Report, runners to your mark, get set and put your costume on, a unique way to say trick or treat.
Over 40 running enthusiasts joined the inaugural 5K Fun Run hosted by Rotaract Club of Saipan at the Garapan Fishing Base on Saturday morning. Runners were encouraged to wear their Halloween costumes, and prizes were given to the funniest, scariest, and most creative costumes after they completed the race.
Thank you for joining the Rotaract Club of Saipan's first ever 5K Fun Run.
Christian Lam, who wears a priest costume, ruled the men's division. He finished the race in 20 minutes and 7 seconds.
Rotorack 5K fun run, finish your medal.
Mr. Barefoot runner himself, Chong Nam Lee, came second place with a time of 22 minutes and 34 seconds. Third place is Shigeki Tenorio, and he crossed the finish line 13 seconds behind Lee. In the women's division, Rosemary Chisato finished the 5-kilometer race in 24 minutes and 51 seconds, winning first place. Second place is Tara Allen with a time of 26 minutes and 25 seconds. Heather Brooke dresses up as Catwoman with her daughter in a ladybug costume, coming in at third place with a time of 26 minutes and 29 seconds. And for the Halloween costume contest, Leo Wanya, wearing the Japanese sumo wrestler costume, bagged the funniest category. Meanwhile, the scariest costume category goes to Marcelita Maglalan. And the most creative costume winner is Rosemary Maritita. Rotaract Club of Saipan President Richard Balieres has this to say about this inaugural event.
This event is the Rotaract Club of Saipan inaugural 5K fun run. It's our first ever fun run. We've always wanted to do one since 2021, which was last year, when Kuya Ricky Castro, who's a former Interact alumni in the Philippines, recommended to us to do a 5K fun run as our fundraiser. And so we've always wanted to do one. And of course, with the challenges of COVID-19, we weren't able to do it last year. However, with the support of Run Saipan, we were able to hold one here on the weekend before Halloween. That's why we also took up the Halloween theme for our 5K fun run and introduced a costume contest.
Raising funds for their community service project, as well as promoting a healthy lifestyle, are the two main reasons in initiating this event.
The reason why we want to do this fun run is so we can promote cardiovascular activity and better lifestyle. I love how the community is engaging or starting to make small changes in their lifestyle, especially with Governor Torres' Fit to Lead initiative and with all the other 5Ks and run events that Run Saipan has been doing. So promoting a healthy lifestyle is definitely one of the 7 areas of focus of Rotary International, and we want to target that. But also at the same time, we also wanted to raise funds for our community service projects, as well as contribute a portion of the proceeds to Rotary International's Polio Plus.
And here are the highlights of this inaugural event.
Baby.
Story KSPN weather report. Partly sunny with isolated showers. East northeast wind 3 to 7 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy with isolated showers. North wind 3 to 7 miles per hour. High 87, low 76. The humidity 84%. Tomorrow, partly sunny with isolated showers. North northeast wind 6 to 9 miles per hour. High 87, low 76. The marine forecast combined seas of 3 to 5 feet will increase to 4 to 6 feet Thursday and then 5 to 7 feet Saturday as north swell produced by a strong low pressure moving off Japan moves into the waters. Northeast wind 5 knots, wind waves 2 feet or less, northeast swell 3 to 5 feet. Sunrise will be at 6:13 a.m., high tide at 3:50 p.m., low tide 9:31 p.m., and the sunset 5:47 p.m. And that does it for your midweek edition of the new sports and weather here in the Marianas. We thank you so much for watching. We hope you have a great night, and we'll see you with more news on Friday.